2 million people living in these islands have now become accustomed to scanning the sky. All too many of you may have seen the... So we here in the center can claim most of the thrills. After standing near the fires and often amid the destruction, I'll tell you the things which impressed me most. First, the firefighters, auxiliary services. Even the dangers from continued bombardment were forgotten in their knife-edged keenness to do their duty. It is the second fire of London comes to be... And during their breathing spells, few and far between, a cigarette is smoked with unbelievable relish and with amazing content. The damage, of course, has its tragedies and its curiosities. Buses were blown across roads. One actually lodged its front wheels in a first-floor window. Against depressing damage, somewhat twisted smiles, they damned Hitler and all his works. I muttered a prayer of thanks that this school was empty when it was hit, for I was sadly impressed by the clear evidence that the bombing was indiscriminate. Of that there is no doubt. Except for the attacks on docks and rail lines, it was just pepperbox bombing. I remember wondering if the German pilot recalled vividly a scene of years ago. Guardsmen lying behind road barricades and firing at one of these houses in the same street with Mr. Churchill standing watching, almost in the line of fire. Now, as Prime Minister, he sees this destruction caused by... And these are the people whose houses were destroyed. They indeed have laughed in the face of death. In bombing, shepherding wardens guided 250 people to a shelter. Bombs fell quite close, but not one person sheltering was hurt. Of course, the people's spirit impelled the King's admiration. His Majesty made an almost immediate tour of the affected districts, talked to the sufferers, who often drove away the King's expressly and good humor. Sky, the thrill comes the most in these men who deserve headlines have been the main target and seeing something like this. Results, sight a Sidney Street in the face of wrecked homes and the fate. Colossal work of remaking them. And if Hitler repeats this terror raiding in your city, you will all certainly be the same. For like all us mad Britishers, defeat is not in us. And I am sure it is admiration of this determined spirit which preoccupies the King as he leaves the area.